Hey, welcome to Moo Moo Math. Today we're going to talk about simplifying rational expressions. What that means is we are going to have some fractions, which are rational, but we're going to have some variables in them. So they're going to look something like this, and we're going to learn how to simplify those and how to reduce them. So let's start off with some basics here. We're talking about dividing. Okay, so I call this the double stack because we have a fraction over another fraction. So I kind of think of this as a double stacked hamburger. Okay, what we want to do is we want to take it from a double stacked hamburger and write it long ways as a hot dog. So I'm going to rewrite this as 1/2, and I'm going to write it as divided by 3/4. So that's really what this means. You've got a fraction divided by another fraction, so I've written it from a double stack to long ways. Now we know that when we're dividing fractions, we actually can use the rule, keep it, change it, and flip it. So we're going to keep the first fraction as 1/2. We're going to change this to multiplication, and we're going to flip, which is called the reciprocal. We can flip the last one. Okay, now we can simplify this by just multiplying straight across. So I get 4 on top, 1 times 4 is 4, and 2 times 3 is 6, and now we just reduce that to 2/3. So that's our answer. When we divide 1/2 divided by 3/4, our answer is 2/3. Now let's take this concept and apply it to rational expressions. Okay, so same concept applies. We have a fraction divided by another fraction. So we're going to write it from a double stack to a long fraction or long problem. So x over 2 divided by x squared plus 2x over 4. Now let's use the keep it, change it, flip it rule. So we're going to keep the first fraction x over 2. We're going to change this to multiplication. And we're going to flip or take the reciprocal of the second fraction. Now, I need to reduce this. Okay, how do I reduce a rational expression? Well, I have to factor it. So now I'm going to try to find all my factors and try to cancel those factors. So let's see. X over 2, it does not factor. It's down to prime factors. But a 4 is a 2 times 2. And then in the denominator here, x squared plus 2x, I can factor out an x, and I'm left with x plus 2. Now, I can cancel at this point. So any factor that's common in the top, which is the numerator, I can cancel with a factor in the denominator on the bottom. So I can now cancel this x with this x, a 2 and a 2. And I'm left with a 2 on top. In my numerator, x plus 2 on the bottom. And now I can't cancel this 2 with this 2 because this is an expression and you have to have the whole thing. So I've got a 2 in my numerator and an x plus 2 in my denominator, and that is my final answer. So that simplifies from this double stack down to just 2 over x plus 2. Now let's look at one more of those. This one actually has an extra step. So this one we have two separate fractions in the numerator divided by x over 2. So the first thing I need to do is simplify the top so I need to get this down to one fraction. Okay? In order to get this to one fraction, I have to get a common denominator. Well, my common denominator, I have an x and I have a 3, so 3x is my common denominator. And that means I need to multiply the first fraction by 3. So that's going to be 3 on top and a 3x on the bottom. The second fraction I need to multiply by x to get a 3x. So that's going to give me x squared over 3x, and I'm adding those. So that's going to simplify to what? 3 plus x squared, or you can put the x squared first if you want, all over 3x. And then I'm still dividing by this x divided by 2. Now I'm going to take it from a double stack to a long problem. So let's rewrite this as 3 plus x squared over 3x divided by x over 2. And then I'm going to keep it, change it, and flip it. So that becomes, and I'm just going to switch the order of these. It's just rewriting it. If there's nothing that's different, 3 times x times 2 over x. Now, I need to see if anything will cancel. Well, I have an x squared plus 3 in the top and a 2 and a 3x and then another x. I don't have anything common top and bottom, so I can't cancel anything out. So I'm just going to bring everything over, write my coefficient, which is 2 first, and then times x squared plus 3. And then in the denominator, I have 3 times x, so I have 3x squared. And that's my final answer. So I hope this video was helpful, kind of walking you through how to simplify rational expressions. If you like this, let us know. You can visit Moo Moo Math, give us a thumbs up, and share. Thank you.